Hey guys, welcome to the next Defenders Retrospective series we are doing here at the Watchmen channel. Today I will be looking back at the show named Luke Cage. So here's the thing with Luke Cage. I actually have only seen half the show, which was about 5 episodes. And then I was so busy to the point where I couldn't find the time to watch the rest. So today I'm going to do something interesting. First of all, I'm going to do a retrospective on the first 5 episodes. And then in the second part of this video, I'm going to watch the rest of the show. And in the second part of the video, I'm going to basically review the show. Basically review it the second after I watched it. So I think that's gonna have like a fun little dynamic there. So let's start with the first 5 episodes of the show. I thought it was a well done show. The thing about Netflix shows is that I think Daredevil was a good show, but the thing about Daredevil is that it was a bit boring at times for my tastes. And then I watched Jessica Jones, same happened there. I thought it was even worse than Daredevil, but it was still enjoyable to a point. And then Daredevil season 2 came out and it opened with a bang, and I thought to myself, this is going to be a great season. And it was true. In season 2 of Daredevil was great, but eventually kind of fell off. It slowed down in the middle is what I'm trying to say. But with Luke Cage, from episode to episode, I realized that the show had a very good pace. In every episode there was something pivotal happening. In like the first episode we find out who Luke Cage is, then later on we find out his origin, then his prison, obviously a part of origin, then his father figure dies, and in every episode something important happens, and that speaks to me because, well, in Jessica Jones and Daredevil you had these decent shows, but the thing about them is that what I realized about these Netflix shows overall is that they were taking too long. They were taking their time a bit too long. For example, in Jessica Jones, there's this one episode where the entire episode is just one scene. And it's the interrogation room where the purple man is trapped and he can't really tell anyone what to do. I think you guys know what I mean. Luke Cage appears in that show, in that episode, I mean. It was too long of an episode, it dwelled too long on the scene, and I did not appreciate that. It was just getting a bit too boring, you know, how more can you do in one scene? But with Luke Cage, everything was seamless. And just like with every Netflix show, I realized there is a hallway scene, and Luke Cage had his. It was basically, I believe the actor's name is Michael Coulter? Yes, I think that's his name. He was badass in that scene. He walked up, he smashed walls, he did the hand gesture like, come on, come at me. It was great. Too bad Jessica Jones didn't have a hallway scene, did she? Well, what I'm trying to say is Luke Cage was, the first 5 episodes were great. They had action pack and, well, let's talk about the characters now. Luke Cage, played by Mike Coulter, and many compare him to Henry Cavill, Superman, the newest one. They compare him and say that he is a good actor, but he doesn't have much to do. And I kind of see what they're talking about, because Superman in the recent movies, he doesn't really say a lot or doesn't have that much of an emotional spectrum. The same is here, you know, the main actor who portrays Luke Cage. He is good, he is very heartwarming, you get that vibe off of him, but you don't really see him do anything crazy with his acting chops, right? So, and Luke Cage is great. The amount of one-liners he has is perfect. The back and forth he has with Misty Knight, and I think Misty Knight I'm gonna do it like a transition here, I guess. Misty Knight is a great character. I think she is funny, quippy, she is confident, and she brings something to the show that keeps it rolling, even in the longer scenes. She is the most interesting part of the show, even when she's playing basketball with those kids in the first five episodes. I can't remember which episode it was, but it was hilarious. And she has her cop friend who, well, we find out who isn't really the best guy, I'll try to put it that way. And then we have Cottonmouth, who is a great villain, by the way, played by Hersha Ali, and I'm hoping I'm pronouncing that name right. He is a great villain. You know, he sometimes, but he doesn't, just like Luke Cage, he doesn't have like a range, or you can see he's not really getting out of his comfort zone, but he is playing the character fairly well and faithful to what they're trying to do with the show. And I think the show is good. What else can I say about the first five episodes? The origin was done very nicely, emotional. It has a little nod to the original costume of Luke Cage, and I'm really a fan of it. The death of Luke Cage's father figure was very emotional. It was that character alone himself. He was that hope, little hope, and when he dies, it's like it perishes, and it's so sad. And for that, I am a huge fan of the Luke Cage series. Now, those are the first five episodes. I'm going to watch the rest of it, which I heard it drops down in quality. I will be the judge for myself. I'll come back. I'll let you know if it is as good or worse than the previous five episodes. So I'll come back in literally a second. And we're back. Like I said I would, I wasn't lying. So I've finally seen all the episodes in the season one of Luke Cage, episode 6 to 13, and I'm able to review the show, do a little retrospective, much more fairly. So I want to talk about the rest of the episodes, episode 6 to 13, and right away I want to talk about Misty Knight. Yes, I think that Misty Knight, that the remaining episode even solidified my opinion that she is the best thing about this show. She has a lot of emotional scenes in episode 6 when her friend dies, her fellow cop, and that very struck a chord with me. It also showed that the actress has at least some range, and I really liked where she was heading with her story arc, basically. And at the end she has that little she's wearing the nod to the comics, the outfit at the very end when she comes into the Harlem Paradise Club. Yeah, she was my favorite character. As for others, Luke Cage was consistently good. Cottonmouth, I'm gonna talk about him a bit later on. Claire, I did not expect to like Claire this much. In when she appeared in Daredevil, I thought she was an okay character. When she appeared in Jessica Jones season 2, I thought she was shoved in. And then we had her in season 2 of Daredevil. She was a nice addition, but still, I didn't see the purpose of her being there. She felt like something just there for the sake of later having an excuse to bring all the defenders together. But in Luke Cage, she matters a lot to the plot. Not only to the plot, but Luke Cage, she interacts with almost every main character within that show. And I think that's a very impressive thing they did with the character, since they weren't really able to do that with the previous shows. So I really like the new villain that they introduced, who turns out to be Diamondback, who later turns out to be Luke Cage's half-brother. Now, I know that some people didn't like the switch from Cottonmouth to Diamondback, but I myself very much, even though I would have preferred having Cottonmouth have a little bit more spotlight, I really liked Diamondback and what he did with him, although his final fight was, his outfit was a bit silly for my taste, and he had great chemistry, great actor, and the things they did with the show was very entertaining. It kept on going, it didn't have any slow moments that were too long, and I don't want to go on a bit too long, so I just want to quickly list off the negatives. There weren't many, but there were some. I already mentioned one was killing off Cottonmouth. I didn't mind him being killed by the counselor. Oh, she was a great character, the counselor of the city. She was great. I want to add that in there. She was amazing. The actress who played her really captured the delivery. But anyway, I don't want to go too long on too long. And so Cottonmouth, I wished he had two more episodes at least. I needed him to have that key face-off with Luke Cage. So that's the first one. The show didn't, like I say, my previous problems with the other Netflix shows is that they kind of dwell too long. They stretch out their episodes. It feels like they're basically dwelling on each scene. But with Luke Cage, we didn't have that. Well, we didn't have that, but then we had certain scenes that could have been a bit handled a tiny bit quicker. And then we have, I believe it was in episode 10, when the cops were searching for Luke Cage, and they couldn't find him, so they started going after kids on the street. They started bringing them into the interrogation room, and then they started beating the kids up, and I thought that was a bit too much for my taste. I think that was overdone, so yeah, that was a negative for me. And for some people, I heard many complaints about from other people that they thought that after they killed off Cottonmouth, it went downhill because it went a bit too Black Lives Matter. I personally didn't get that. There were like couple moments in episode 12 where they were kind of doing like the, oh, it's so great to see a bulletproof black man, which I didn't mind. I mean, it was a bit black power thing, which I'm not a fan of, but in this instance it didn't bother me. Then we had what else did we have? We had the moment where they started complaining how Luke Cage is being haunted. He's running away because he's black, and I thought to myself, well, you also missed out the part where he has powers, he's bulletproof, he's different from everyone else, and he's running away from cops, and that he escaped. So yeah, that part was a bit annoying, but overall Luke Cage is personally my favorite TV show on Netflix, because it very much doesn't, like I said, it doesn't dwell on things. It has decent action scenes, although not as good as Daredevil. Daredevil has much more superior action scenes, but it had a bit of good in each. It had good action sequences, it had good acting, it had pretty much all of the bases covered. So for that, even though I'm not a fan of superhero TV shows, I'm gonna give this one an 8.4 out of 10, which to me is great. And although that is a low bar for superhero TV shows, I think that it's a step in the right direction. So tell me in the comments if you guys, what's your favorite Netflix TV show, and do you guys like the Netflix TV shows more than me? They're definitely better than the CW ones over at DC. And yeah, we're gonna have a couple more. I think we're gonna have Iron Fist Retrospective coming out soon, and then we're gonna do that Defenders podcast, so make sure you're out for that. And yeah, my name is Olaf, and peace out.